And it's the same in Da Vinci Code. Poor Jesus Christ has to fuck, has to make love to cover up the fact that they don't here. No? And it's the same then in The Lost Symbol, which is such a bad novel, I cannot imagine. Such a bad novel. And interestingly enough, so that you will not say that I dream, in Angels and Demons, which is the last film, in the novel there is sex, in the film it's not. You see how interesting it is? Usually Hollywood does the opposite. It introduces sex even when there is no sex. Here it's the opposite, my God. What happens with Hollywood when it is erasing sex even where there is sex in? So what kind of tendency in this? Ah, now I will try to provide you an answer with, I claim we effectively, now this is a big psychoanalytic speculation, are entering a new era, at least in the so-called developed West, I don't envy them, where effectively, how to put it, love encounter as a couple is considered too traumatic, like yesterday, was it Hindu Times or Hindu Standard, there was, I read it here, there was a wonderful report on how, and from Badiou, I learned the same thing goes on in France. You know what's the latest fashion in Western United States? To look at the positive message of what you are supposed to know, these pre-arranged marriages. They say they are the wise solution, only instead of parents, we should have psychologists, scientists, and so on and so on. The idea is that one French agency wonderfully propagates its services saying, we will enable you to be in love without falling in love. Like, you know, to avoid this shocking encounter fall, we will look scientifically who is the ideal partner. And then Robert Epstein, and I read it yesterday, I think, he even claimed that he has the precise strategy of, he uses some complex term, like emotion-enhancing practices or whatever, how he artificially, by following certain rituals, then guarantees that you will fall in love. So, I claim that these are no longer these old passionate couples. We are effectively entering some kind of a, how should I call it, pervert narcissistic economy where even love is reduced to some kind of a anal, pre-edipal relationship. What do you mean by this? The same Darian leader gave me a wonderful interpretation of, I quote it somewhere, of a beautiful, simple slip of tongue, mistake of one of his patients. He told me, one of his patients told him how he wanted to seduce a girl. So, they went to a restaurant, afterwards he wanted to take her to a hotel room, But he made a slip of tongue when entering the restaurant, instead of saying a table for two, please, he said a bed for two, please, no? Now, it's ingenious how he interpreted this slip. Not as, oh, his dirty mind was already on, but as a kind of a fear. What his fear was that his oral instincts, eating their well, will mean more to him that he will just get fat, full, stuck, and will not be interested in sex. It was a kind of a defensive measure of saying to him, I must not eat too much here, I must remember that the true aim, you know, it was kind of a protective measure against oral economy. It was, I must remember, I'm really here for later, not too much of this, and so on.